Chitty chitty bang bang. Oh.
In every family, there's that one uncle, cousin, or aunt that just ain't right. But for whatever reason, you love them anyway. It's the family.
A son does not want to hear his mother say, skeet, skeet.
It's the family.
Twerking is not a talent, all right? Stripping is not a career.
Wow. It is not.
The Family Radio Podcast.
Yeah, don't have your kids cussing on the internet, but do have your kids dancing on the internet. Ooh, kill them. kill them.
The Family Radio Podcast.
You're going too far. No such place.
Oh!
I want to go to the abyss! Never!
The Family Radio Podcast with T-Boogie, Gene.com, and Chill Will.
It's the family.
Hey, hey, it's T-Boogie.
And Chill Will. Gene.com is taking a sick day today. He's under the weather.
I know. A little too much partying.
Coughing like crazy. You know what it was? Hey, did you see his Instagram post?
R&B Chronicles.
Yes. So, look, when you in the bed with a skull cap on, you either sick or they done drove you crazy.
You had a time last night.
We had a time.
So,
that's
what it looked like to me.
Yeah, man. Gene wasn't ready for them for the January Capricorn. He wasn't ready for that. Yo, make sure if you're in Jacksonville, check out R&B Bingo. We hope Gene gets better. Don't forget to follow him on his socials. All that good stuff.
Gene.com.
Yes. Boog, can you believe that it's almost Black History Month. It's pretty much the end. Like, January has... I looked around, we're more than halfway through. End of the first week, then I look around, it's the end of the second week, then I'm like, this is, wow. Once again, this year's
flying
moving.
Flying by.
2023. Question I have for you, Book. I'm not going to ride on you about Black Panther. I'm going to let that rest because we're coming up on Black History Month, so I'm not going to talk about that. I'm going to let Gene ride out on you.
I'm going to let that be.
But have you taken down your decorations?
For the most part, yes.
What do you mean for the most part? You either take them down or you don't. Because I thought you trade yours out, right?
But they have to be, yes, but they have to be, you know, put away properly. The breakables have to be rewrapped.
In my storage bins that go out to the garage.
Yes, it has to be organized. So, yes. Christmas is down. Valentine's Day is just about done. It's up. I'm good.
Okay, so that's what you're doing. You're trading out Christmas for Valentine's Day.
Absolutely. The inflatable goes up this weekend.
The pagan holiday for lovers. Okay.
Yes.
Inflatable do you have for Valentine's Day?
Remember, it's seven different hearts. They're connected, and they have the little sweet heart sayings on it.
And you're going to have that in your front yard. That's going to be in your front yard.
Of course.
You're going to be the only one in the neighborhood with some shit in their front yard for Valentine's Day. I know you.
And? They be hating on me. I'm telling you, I watch my neighbors. They try to step their inflatable game up every year because of me. I got it on lock. They don't know.
Okay, so what comes after Valentine's Day? What are you?
Spring / Easter.
Okay, that's because I have, you know what? That's crazy. I have seen Easter stuff in the store.
At my house?
In the stores this week. Like, I have seen some Easter stuff.
We're ready. Comes
up. And that ain't Easter until when? April?
Yep.
Wow.
We ready.
Okay, I see you already. Why didn't you have a big inflatable head of Martin Luther King that you put in your yard?
For MLK Day.
What's up with that?
Do I need a big inflatable
with MLK, like the big letters that you sit in your yard?
Should I, just like how I have the inflatable that spells out fa la 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 la,
oh
I have to have one that says, don't play on the holiday, work to find a better way.
King holiday. That's what we need to have, the king holiday.
He had a dream.
So here's the thing. So did you work on the king holiday?
Actually, I did.
You did.
And one of my coworkers, she said to me, you working on Monday? I said, yeah. She's like, they didn't give the Negro the day off. I said, well, apparently they don't consider me the Negro. Damn.
Look, I was supposed to. I was supposed to do some things, and I'm purposely I don't like ever since the King holiday has been a federal holiday.
Official?
Yeah,
okay.
I'm not working that day.
Mm.
I'm gonna.
I need to do better.
I'm gonna think about the dream. You know how hard they fought for this holiday. I'm gonna think about the dream.
Real.
I'm gonna try to do some acts of service.
So do you think it should be mandatory that all Black people don't work that day?
It shouldn't be mandatory, but I just think in our spirit, you know,
we should give us the day off.
No, we shouldn't do it. We shouldn't work. I feel like we should not work on MLK Day.
Put in your PTO.
Yeah.
No, it's a federal holiday, so you act well if you work.
Some businesses, well, you know, it's a holiday for them. Other businesses, it's not.
Right.
And then some businesses, you know, don't close at all if you police.
Hello, retail does not give a shit about MLK.
Look,
retail
only closes when Easter, Christmas, and
that's
it.
What do you mean Easter? No, you must be thinking public. No, there's a lot of stores open on Easter. It's mainly Christmas, and this 2022 was the first time that we saw stores go back to closing on Thanksgiving Day.
Yeah, yeah, because usually,
you know what I'm saying, but Christmas
Day
is pretty much just the only one.
Really? I thought I was talking about Easter too.
Mm. Mm-mm, that's just Publix.
Publix said we're gonna let our people out. Now Publix will close early too because I got caught up in it. I went to Publix, them doors was closed.
Ooh.
And I was like, yo, what's up?
Like you looking at your watch, like what?
Yeah, y'all ain't.
What is going on?
Like, nope. Y'all ain't got none of them chicken wings in there waiting for me. Nope, we're closed.
Mm-mm. Yep.
Another shameless plug for Publix, because they need.
We do it all the time.
Me. They need to be paying me, yo, for the summer. For right now, they got them Nashville hot wings and tenders. Yo.
Oh.
Let me tell
are
you
they breaded? The wings
they're
are
breaded.
They breaded.
They're breaded.
Okay.
It's just the Nashville hot seasoning. Let me tell you something.
I like the Mardi Gras ones.
I like the Mardi Gras ones too, but let me tell you, I tried that Nashville hot tenders yesterday. Boog. Like seriously, I was sucking on an ice cube. Like my mouth was on fire. I really went and drunk some milk. Like I normally don't do. I can take spicy stuff, you know. But like I went and drunk some milk and like this is supposed to, you know, help with
right, my, right.
Yes, and it did help.
Oh, wow.
Let me
they
tell
trying
you
to kill a nigga,
that thing,
huh?
That thing was on fire. It was good though too. It was good, but that thing was
okay,
on fire. And then,
you know, there's a difference. You can have spicy and there's no flavor, or you can have spicy with flavor.
Yeah, that Nashville hot.
Okay.
And if you go to your local Publix and they don't have it, just ask the people at the deli and they can make it.
Publix is so nice.
Oh,
you can ask them for anything.
Oh my gosh. And they do it with a smile. Like it's hot. Like, yes. Like you go in there and like they don't have any wings. They have the 20 piece wing. I say, hey, excuse me, sir. Can you split that up? Can you give me 10 of those? Yeah, no problem. Let me do it, no problem.
Okay. Wait. They will cut your chicken, they'll separate your wing and your wingette, your drumette.
Really?
Pieces.
I didn't know they would do that.
Yes.
I'm telling you.
What? You pick up that package and ask them, hey, can you separate this for me? I'll be back. That should be ready when
Look,
you get back.
Let me tell you something. Publix Deli, that's God's.
Damn, I left the bell home. Hit the bell on Publix.
Oh, I got it. Look, let me tell you something. Those people that work at Publix Deli, y'all doing God's work. I appreciate everything y'all do.
You know what?
I appreciate y'all. That's God's work right there. And let me tell you this. Look, I'm going to stop this shameless plug in a minute. But if you join the Publix, like, you know, I got the Publix app on my phone because they always have the BOGOs, you know, buy one, get one free and stuff like that. So I need to make sure every week what they got on sale. So, you know, you put your birthday in it. How about for my birthday? They sent me an email like, hey, it's your birthday. We're going to give you it was one of the smaller like sheet cakes. Well, last year they gave me like a big, two big cupcakes.
Oh,
so
wow.
And they give you a choice. You can either get the cupcakes or you can get a half gallon of ice cream, the Publix ice cream. And so this year, the same thing. They say, hey, you can either get ice cream or you can get the birthday. It's not a sheet. It's a half a sheet cake or smaller sheet cake. Like it's enough to share, you know, but it's not one, of the, it's not one of the big sheet cakes. Yeah.
Right.
And it's for free because it's your birthday.
Shoot. I had no clue. See?
Yeah.
So, I need to get down with that.
Yeah, you need to. So, yeah, public, you know, they're my peoples. But like I said, y'all doing God's work up there in that Publix Deli.
you know,
it's God's work, right?
I'm not co-signing that.
Chick-fil-A. My pleasure. I'm gonna start saying it to them.
Wasn't I on the phone with you earlier this week when I went through the drive through someplace and the person was like, "My pleasure," and I'm like, "No, only Chick-fil-A should do that."
Yeah, you can't say that.
No, because like they've become known for that. So yeah. You can't, everybody biting off of it now. You have Burger King, you got old Ratchet, people talking about my pleasure.
You can't do it.
No, it's just not the same. Don't do it. If you're not Chick-fil-A, leave it alone. Stay away from it.
Look, Boog, as a former Jacksonville Jaguars season ticket holder, how are you feeling right now? Team is in the playoffs. We got the first playoff home win in a long time this past weekend.
You know what else I noticed, though?
What else did you notice?
Cord from the Jaguars, he stopped calling me. He's like, "Oh, bitch, you going to call me now."
Oh, no, them ticket prices about to go up. That's what's going to happen.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah. He ain't going to call me no more. Mm-mm. He's like, "She'll be calling us. Everybody's going to want back in now."
They are. But the game was, like I said, a home playoff game, which we haven't had. Well, look, the Jaguars haven't been in the playoffs for forever and a day. And
okay.
Let me tell you something. This week, well, not even this week, maybe in the middle of the season, I have a new respect for the quarterback, Trevor Lawrence.
Okay. Oh, me too.
I have a new respect.
Definitely.
And understand.
Hit the bell for Trevor Lawrence.
I look at, because he played for Clemson. If you follow sports, he was the quarterback at Clemson. He's always had success. He went to high school in Georgia. He's from Georgia. His high school, went to the state playoffs, won. He went to college. He did great in college. But sometimes that does not translate into the NFL. You can be a great college player, come to NFL, and you get smoked. Yep. Understand, the dudes are bigger. The dudes are faster. The game goes quicker, But Trevor Lawrence had in his first year – well, we had a bad coach, and we had what's his name? I can't even think of his name. Jaguars had a sucky coach, yeah. I think they kind of didn't do what they were supposed to do with him, train him well or whatever. Look, this year, Trevor Lawrence is on fire. Jaguars started out, 1-6 or something like that? And since then, they turned the corner, and, he has been balling.
What? He spent the block on y'all,
yes.
And he's doing it.
But this week,
I'm happy for him. Very happy for him.
I am too. But this week, it has been confirmed to me. And write this down because I'm gonna say it. Trevor Lawrence is black.
Hit the bell.
He is black. Let me tell you.
And
a lot of things people don't realize. Understand. This is the first. This is the first inkling when I said, okay, Trevor Lawrence might be down for the cause.
He is. I believe it.
But let me tell you what happened. No, do you know that a lot of people don't know, and they didn't really put this in the media because it was Super Bowl weekend. Do you remember when Kodak Black got shot when the Super Bowl was in L.A.?
Yes.
It was at the Justin Bieber party?
Yes.
A lot of people don't know that Trevor Lawrence was there.
I think me and you might have talked about that last year.
So Trevor Lawrence in the house when
Kodak
Black
got
shot. So in my mind, I'm like, what Trevor Lawrence doing at the party? But I mean, it was a Super Bowl party, so people are all over the place. So yeah, so he was at that party. Now he went, and the word I got was him and his wife left right before the foolishness went down. But he was there. He was up in there. Okay, he was up in there. Now that's the first thing. The second thing, this weekend after they won the game. Him, his wife, he took some players to Waffle House.
Motherfucking Waffle House.
The WH. It's all on the internet. Like, it was like people were just like, he.
A lot of us knew it because we saw it locally first.
Think about it. The fans. So you, after the game, we had a good game. We won. You look up, Trevor Lawrence rolling up in there. In the Waffle House.
That shit almost brought a tear to my eye. They was clapping it up for him and everything.
They better be glad I wasn't in there, because I would have stood up and said, "Hey, put his smothered and chunked on my bill." All right, I got it. I got his hash brown. Whatever you want, homeboy. I got it.
Hey man, he was so motherfucking cool when he walked in there. I mean, he threw his hand up. he acknowledged everybody that was acknowledging him, but it was very clear, like, yo, we came to Waffle House to eat.
Yeah, so I thought that was hilarious.
I appreciate the love. I thought that was hilarious.
And just to give you some more backstory on that, because he was on a radio show this week talking about it, where evidently it was some guys on the team that had never been to Waffle House in their life. And so he had told them, like, during the season, hey, y'all got to go to Waffle House. He's from Georgia, so he know about Waffle House. And so he was like, oh, I'm going to take you out of Waffle House. So let me tell you how cool his wife is. His wife called Waffle House ahead and was like, hey, I'm coming with some. Can y'all get us a booth? Make sure we got a booth. I got some hungry dudes coming. And so she called, and Waffle House don't really make reservations.
Right, but shit, if I answered the phone and they say Trevor Lawrence is coming through, listen, I'm roping off the booth, okay? Yes. If I got to use my apron to do it.
How crazy was that?
Hey, I encountered him in the store, the retail store that I work at when he and the wife first moved to Jacksonville. Yeah. They, came through new house or whatever. They bought up a bunch of shit. And I'm just sitting, and the young lady's casting them out, and I'm like, she didn't even know who that is. Yeah. Had no clue. And I'm like, he was just so cool.
Yeah, that's what he seems like, a cool dude. And in all of the interviews, and I know since he's a quarterback, they go through PR training where you do these fake interviews because we wanted to make sure you represent the team, You don't let nobody put a mic in your face and be like, hey, dog, this what happened. This some bullshit right here. See, the defense ain't play like they were motherfuckers supposed to. They want to make sure that does not happen.
Right, right.
So, I know he's had media training, but no, he's like you can tell he's built. I didn't know if he was going to be built for this. But this past season, since the middle of the season when they've been balling, he built for this. And I'm talking about comebacks. I'm not talking about just playing well. Because hey, the last playoff game, they played the first half, they played horrible.
They were stinking up the field.
Fucking horrible.
Went to sleep and was shocked when I woke up. I was pleasantly surprised, like, oh, you niggas pulled it out.
Look, halftime, he had to brush the shoulders off and get it together, and they came back and won. So and that's not the only game. He's done that three or four games.
Couple of games.
Yeah, this season. So, So once again, I somebody asked me something last week about the team, and I was like, dude, it's the home team. I'm not gonna not cheer for my home team. Yeah, I'm not gonna not do that. Even though I like other NFL teams, but I'm not gonna not cheer for my home team. So they are in the division round this week, playing the Kansas City Chiefs, which this shit is not going to be a cakewalk, man. They're playing Kansas City in Kansas City.
Right. By the time you hear this, they will either be in the middle of the Jaguar send-off.
They're sending the team off.
Or they will have already sent them off. But, hey, man, if you can get out there downtown at the stadium between 9:30 and 11:30, I think.
Yeah.
And,
understand, Jacksonville is still a young team, and they haven't even done this type send-off thing but three times. Remember, the first time is when they almost went to the Super Bowl. What year that was. And then
that was like 97,
They won in Denver, and they came back, and the plane flew over the stadium. The people just went down to the stadium. Like, nobody even told the people to go to the stadium. People just came down to the stadium. And then a couple of years ago, remember, we had Jalen Ramsey. The great pop prophet Jalen Ramsey.
That nigga, man. He kept talking about something.
We going to the Super Bowl. We going to win that bitch. So I miss having Jalen Ramsey on the team, man. I really do. You need somebody who going to act a plum fool no matter what on a team. You do need. Look, just like Wu-Tang had the old dirty bastard, you need somebody
in your squad who you
can't control. You need somebody in your squad who you can't control, who's a loose cannon. You need that.
Yes, that's liable to say anything. Yeah, you need anything.
That. Because when Jalen Ramsey grabbed that mic and said, I ain't got too much to say. I'm just going to say, we're going to the Super Bowl. We're going to win that bitch. And then he said it again. We're going to win that bitch. He said it again. Ooh. Let me tell you something. When I say them faces got red in the front office.
I know they did. God. Who gave Jalen the mic? Oh, my God.
Did he just say bitch on a mic? Said in front of fans?
Exactly. He said bit. That would be B-I-H.
Yeah, he say bitch. He ain't say bitch. He say bitch.
He said, well, we're
like
Clyde.
You know that bitch?
Yeah.
Hey, bitch.
So, yes.
Shout out
proud
to the
of the Jaguars. Definitely proud of the Jaguars. Hey, since we're talking about football, let me ask you this real quick. So, Stephen A. Smith.
Stephen A.
In a little bit of trouble. He was on with Cherry Shepherd the other day. And she asked him about Rihanna doing the Super Bowl. You know, what did he think? Well, first off, he's a big Beyonce fan. And he made the mistake of saying she ain't no Beyonce. Oh, nigga.
Oh, yeah, you probably
shouldn't
have said
that. You know, Rihanna fans. Yeah, he probably shouldn't have said that.
You shouldn't have said that.
I feel like I understand what he meant. They're not the same.
Yeah, don't divide and conquer, though, because we all under, you know, that's all Rock Nation, man. Don't divide and conquer like that.
The machine that's behind Beyonce is not the same machine that's behind Rihanna. Okay,
yeah.
So he's like, oh, Beyonce is the greatest entertainer and so on and so forth. Not to disrespect Rihanna, but they're both very talented women, but I'm standing behind. It's not the same machine behind Rihanna as it is Beyonce. Yeah. Okay, so I don't feel like you can compare.
Yeah.
Oh, and he feels like the Beyonce's halftime performance was, you got to be able to beat that, plus the Coldplay one and the Bruno Mars one. I was like, he said last year's was good, but you know, you got to beat the Beyonce and Coldplay and the Bruno Mars.
This is the pinnacle of a performer's career when you do the Super
Bowl.
You have so many eyes on you, so you do want to do the best show. So usually whoever's doing it, they bring out all the stops. I'm still like that whole Shakira, J-Lo. Shakira could have brought out Wyclef. Shakira. You know, but she ain't want to do that. That's just my personal thing, because I thought that would be hot if Wyclef would have came out there. But anyway, but of course, like, look, Dr. Dre, Mary, 50, Snoop, that shit was
Eminem,
that shit was epic. Even down to the low riders on the field and the Dre got the soundboard up there. Like, that shit was epic. Beyonce's halftime shows, that shit was, as she brought out Destiny's Child, she got all these dancers on the field. You know, it once again, this is a epic performance.
It's a great performance. Yes.
I'm really looking, like, I don't know what to expect from Rihanna. I'm really looking forward to it. Do I think she can do it? Hell yeah. Rihanna's been in this business a long time. Y'all keep forgetting.
She was a teenager.
Yeah, y'all keep forgetting because she's fucking the hell with music. I'm selling draws and selling makeup. So I don't need to do music anyway. She doesn't. She does not need to do music. So this is her coming back. And I'm really looking forward to it. I don't know who she's going to bring out. Yeah, just like you said, but she's been in this shit for years. This the Pond to Replay girl. All right.
Yes, hit the ball on that.
Don't fuck around. This Riri has Riri's no slouch.
Remember, she went from Pun to Replay to the bad girl, Riri, and we started seeing her growth, her evolution into a woman. Like you said, now she's selling drawers and makeup.
Yeah,
she's good.
She
got a baby.
Yeah, she don't have to do this music thing. And I remember when they announced her. Like, I heard somebody hollering, oh, why didn't they let Taylor Swift do it? You know why? Because Riri got way more motherfucking hits than Taylor Swift. Go to the, look at the stats. Men lie, women lie, numbers don't. Look at the fucking numbers. And then that person shut the hell up, because you see, that's why Rihanna's doing the Super Bowl. Now, I don't know how y'all let The Weeknd slip in to do a fucking Super Bowl, because he definitely shouldn't have done that bullshit.
Oh my God.
I digress.
That's neither
I'm leave
here
that alone.
Nor thank you.
I digress.
We're going to leave that back there, okay? What was that? 2020?
I don't know when it was. That's the one that was in Tampa. But yeah, I'm really looking forward. I don't know what Rihanna's going to bring to the table, but I know she's going to bring some shit to the table. And don't forget, Jay-Z's hand is on this. Two.
Right, and again, she does have Rock Nation.
Yeah, yeah. So
this is the Super Bowl. Yeah.
So it's I'm looking forward to it. Don't look, Stephen A. Smith. Stephen A. Smith was here in town in Tampa for the Dallas and the Bucks game.
Yep. Oh,
yeah, he
did
the show.
Bucks.
Yeah, he did the show live here in Tampa. And once again, you know, I got to get up to the Bucks. I mean, they're going home. Tom Brady. I think this is probably his last game in a Bucks uniform. I feel like
I read that earlier this week.
Yeah,
he's
I feel
good.
He's gonna
We're
go.
Good.
He's gonna go to somebody next year. I don't know who, but
it's
I feel
okay.
like he's gonna
sit down,
play
sit down.
Again. What you telling him? Sit down.
Yeah, we're good. We're Boog, good.
He's
Tom.
The GOAT.
We're good.
He's one of the best to ever do it, Boog.
And sometimes you got to step aside and let the next GOAT ride.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, so let's talk about something. Actually, once again, if you're just tuning in, Gene is taking a sick day today. And actually, that's probably for the best because Gene is the only one of us who is married, who got papers on him. So what we're going to talk about now is probably best, Boog, than me and you talk about it. So
we don't want to get Gene in no trouble.
Yeah, we don't.
Over there at the White House.
But check this out. So here's the thing. I'm trying to wean myself off of fucking TikTok. I really am, Boog, because I would get on TikTok and fall down a fucking rabbit hole. I look around. I've been on TikTok 2 hours. Looking at
everything
everything from Karen videos to police pulling people over for some bullshit to, you know, you can look at TikTok and find anything up on there.
Anything
at all. So I fall down a rabbit hole at least twice a day. So I found something and I sent it to you and you text me back, was like, this gotta be a joke. I say, Boog, I don't think it's a joke. This is not a joke.
This is
for real. So let me pull up the video on my phone and let me play it here because this is a real thing for you people that are in the dating world. And so wait, let's see.
During dating, sometimes nap dates are a thing. Are they still in marriage?
Did you say nap dates?
You don't schedule a nap with your person?
First of all, that sounds wonderful.
I know.
What is this life?
Who watches the children
you
when
doing
I do that?
Nap
you having a nap date? Nap, is that a 2022 thing? Y'all taking naps? I will. Is that a nap ministry? Is that what that means?
You've never scheduled a nap? Thank you. Over here, thank you.
Okay.
Because it may not lead to something.
Boog. Nap dates. Have you ever heard of such a thing?
First off, nope, never heard of a nap date, okay?
You schedule a time, and you and that person just cuddle up and nap.
What?
Just like the guy said right there, that don't mean nothing else is going to happen. But you know, Boog, I think we talked about this way, way, way back in the day on the podcast. You know they have these places where people can just go and get hugged. Like you pay $40 and somebody will hug you for 30 minutes. Why are you laughing, Boog? What are you doing? What are you laughing about?
It's ridiculous.
It's true. It's out there. It's out there in this world right now. So they got
places
you can go get hugged.
If you got money, you can buy just about anything you want.
You can. So they got the hug places, but let's talk about this, a nap date. In this date, and we both know it's hot out here in these dating streets.
It is.
But here's the thing. So nap, like, would you even consider that?
Oh, my God. Have we been out previously? I guess we would have to have been.
Oh, you have to. Like, I don't like.
Okay, like,
I don't
you
know you.
A lunch or a dinner. Right. We not about to cuddle up.
We napping and then your wig come off and all. No.
I'm dead.
No,
wow.
That's what's new in the dating world. Go ahead on, Boog.
Okay, I don't deal well with, you know, snorers. So, I mean, is there like a application? Like, we have to discuss this ahead of time? Like, I snore. Okay, well then, no, we can't do it. I'm not even a good napper. That's crazy.
You're not a good napper. Yeah, I didn't know.
I lay there and my brain starts to think about what I should be doing instead of napping, and so it doesn't usually go well for me. Yeah. Maybe a nap date might help me relax. Maybe I don't.
Or establish intimacy with that person, and of course, I don't mean sexually intimacy. I mean just
a closeness. And where is this nap date occurring?
I don't know. I mean, but if you want to go, my theory is always go big or go home. So you want to nap at the Four Seasons, girl? meet me at the Four Seasons.
So now I'm feeling like this is just the setup. This is absolutely the setup. We gonna nap, air quotes, nap.
Wait, a setup for what, Boog? Is it set up to hit it?
Yes, you have got me there. I'm all comfortable cuddling, and you know how men do, y'all. You know.
Wait. What do you mean? What do men do? What are you talking about?
Men like to eat. You know, you spooning, and all of a sudden you start feeling a little something. You know, along
like the song.
Back.
So you feel a poke coming through.
You feel a poke coming through. Okay.
Well, Boog, you can alleviate all of that. You just sleep on your damn back. Then you can alleviate all that.
But I'm not a back sleeper. I'm a side sleeper.
Well, then, get prepared for the poke to come.
No. See, this is a setup.
Y'all are killing
it's
me.
Absolutely
Y'all are
a setup.
Me. Now, look, okay, so let's back it up a little bit. So, yeah, dating has totally changed. You know, Look,
what
just
year
just
are
think
we
about,
even in anymore? Nap dating.
Nap date. But just think about it, Book, how, you know, culturally, if we think back shows like Leave It to Beaver, I Love Lucy, remember, they're married, but they never even showed them in a bed together. Remember shows
sleeping
like that, they had
bed,
separate
right.
beds, you know. So that
I Love
like,
Lucy
yeah.
had two beds in their room.
Yeah, and they had a child. But they wouldn't TV back then. You couldn't show that. Like they didn't want to show that. And of course, dating back then is your what the old people call it, Book. You're courting. Is that what they called it in Jamaica, Book? Courting.
What courting? Yeah. Yes.
That's what they called it in Jamaica.
They
you know,
did.
Y'all got patois for something else. Y'all might call
you
it bumba court or something.
No, we did not. It's just regular old courting. Regular old courting.
But of course, and it has progressed to look to like now, these younger generations, man, they'll meet on the app and be like, all right, let's go do it.
You know what? You are exactly right.
Or like we've heard stories on the news, or they at school in the bathroom fucking and shit. You know, like come on, like. Do you even know her last name?
No one's taking time to establish those types of things anymore.
Yeah, but now the little thing on TikTok that I just played, those were older people talking about nap dates, and they were like, "I ain't never heard of that." Like Jada Pinkett's mom was on there on that panel.
Okay,
they were talking
Grammy Norris.
So that's the thing. So nap, I don't think I would do that. That's what I'm saying, because we would have to be way, way, way into dating, and it ain't called a nap date.
If we've gotten to that point, we're sleeping together.
Yeah.
Shit.
Yeah.
I don't know. I think this new generation. Oh man, they trying to make something out of everything.
A nap date.
Let's do a nap date.
Well, we can't call it some afternoon delight. Do you want some afternoon delight?
See now that's something.
Oh that's
you know, afternoon delight is
afternoon
something totally
delight.
Different than a nap date. Okay, if I get some afternoon delight, I will absolutely fall asleep right away. Okay,
afternoon delight.
I'm just saying. I don't know.
So
this, yeah,
that just really caught my attention, and I say, "Boy, we need to talk about this." A nap date. So would you? So you said you wouldn't do a nap date.
Thumbs down. I'm not doing no nap
date. I don't think
dating.
I would
it
do
just
a nap
seems
date.
Weird. It seems weird.
Because I mean, of course, you always have that awkwardness in date. You know, if you're first dating or you're dating somebody and you're getting to know that person, I still think it's already a level of awkwardness there.
Yes.
So I think that this would definitely, if y'all aren't
heightening
it like that, yeah, it would. You know. Because that's the thing. Like, you're going to take a nap date. All right. You take off your shoes. You might have corns or something. And like, you done fucked this up.
Bye, chill. Goodbye.
What?
Goodbye. Don't do that. Don't do that.
What?
You know, Claudia Jordan just had her foot surgery
she
to get her corns.
She should have.
Removed.
But I'm not mad at Claudia. See, Murder, she was, you know, she was in deal or no deal. She had to wear heels all the time. So she needs to have
a
clap.
She was a track star.
She was a track star.
That's really what messed it up.
She's a runner. She's a track star. It wasn't a track that ran that messed up her feet. It was
you
them
know
heels.
What?
She got to wear all the time.
Stop
y'all
it.
Pay, y'all women pay the price for beauty. Y'all wear some
we
shoes,
do.
Shoes that don't even fit, but it look good with the outfit, so y'all going to wear it.
Depending on how long I got to have them on, it is very possible that I might wear them, and they're not the best fit.
Y'all don't understand. See, y'all paying the price for it. Just look back.
Look
back at the Bible. Jesus paid the price. They killed him.
He paid
the price. So see, y'all out there paying the price with these shoes, putting on 4 and 5 Spanx at one time, can't even breathe.
Going to the Dominican Republic,
getting this work done from somebody who ain't really no doctor. Mm-mm. Y'all stop paying
the price. They failed medical school over here.
Exactly. Y'all paying the price for all of that. Don't pay the price for beauty like that.
Make sure that you are happy with your woman, all natural, okay? Make sure you love her and that fupa.
It's nothing wrong with that, though, Boog. Ain't nothing wrong with that. My thing, here's the problem I have, Boog. My biggest problem with women out there today, y'all learn how to draw these eyebrows on. Can you do that?
Just
the family. We keep it real, right? And I saw a package in the store. It was a stencil, eyebrow stencil.
I'm so sad that you had to see that. It is out there. Yep.
I saw the packet in the store.
So it ain't no reason for your eyebrows to be looking crazy.
If y'all get these eyebrows together, and it was a lady on TikTok, because I don't remember her name. But like, and she's always trying to give advice. And I love people on TikTok who just be trying to give advice, like, y'all, like it's a fucking masterclass and shit. It's fucking TikTok. So like every day she's on there giving advice. And she's a nice looking black lady. She, you know, always have these business suits on. But nigga, them eyebrows be fucked up.
Oh, no. So why you don't hop in her comments?
No, that's not my job. I got too much shit going on in my life to be. Planet Fitness. This is a no judgment zone. I'm not gonna correct you. If you got a mirror at your house and you see how it looks,
you're doing it.
Go ahead. That's what you wanted to do. I'm not gonna correct nobody like that. I'm not doing it. But yeah, every time I look, I just bust out laughing now because I'm like, them eyebrows.
I see on here giving advice, and your eyebrows need help.
So between the eyebrows and between the wigs are a nice accessory. Wigs are a great accessory. But if you gonna half-ass it, if I see glue... Then you ain't doing it right.
That's never good.
You need to go ahead and pay. Yeah, if you ain't paid your money... I totally respect a woman. I've talked to some women before. I didn't even know that was a wig.
And I was like, that's good.
Didn't even know. So evidently, you're gonna pay that money, though, because I heard it ain't cheap.
And that's why sometimes when we see celebrities, you know, with a bad wig, it's like, come on now. Y'all got money enough.
That should not happen.
It should not. Corrine Brown,
she was having money problems. She was having money problems, so don't do that, Boog. She might not have had enough to do. But you have never seen Oprah hair out of place. You have never seen Beyonce's hair out of place. Never. And you will never see that.
Okay.
You have never seen Hoda on the Today Show, her hair. Well, I don't think she wear
weave. She might have weave, but you have never known that
real hair be blended into that fake hair. You would never know. Never.
Listen, you get what you pay for.
So that's my thing. If you're going to do it big. You know, don't mess around with it. I don't need to see the old hair and the new hair. I don't need to see that. You lose points for that.
Okay, and can your part look natural? Don't let that part skin be like a completely different shade from your regular part skin. I'm just saying.
Oh, my gosh. Okay, Boog, so here's the thing, too. So you said no to nap dates, right?
No to nap dates. So
the wig thing. So, Boog, your daughter, would you let her wear wigs? Or at what age would you let her wear wigs?
Can we start with like
I don't know. You tell me. The only reason I'm asking that question, Boog, is because I went to the mall the other day. Actually, it wasn't even the mall. I was in Target. But like, I'm seeing these girls. They got to be 16, 17. Yeah.
Yep.
And I'm like, so your parents pay for that wig? Or like, who's like, and then my thing is, you're too young for your hair to be messed up? Like, why where are you?
To be
where,
snapping
where
out your edges at yeah. that age. What is wrong with your?
Yeah. Where you at?
Listen.
So that's why I asked you. That's why I asked you. Like, what? Would you even let her do
Maybe 16, you know, you're going to a homecoming dance or a prom or, you know, something.
I see that.
But I'm not a big you rocking the wig every day to school type. But no, we don't need to. We're not paying for all of
that. Yeah, that's a lot of maintenance,
special occasion. Right? Yes. Okay. Special occasion. You know, I can see that. No, we're not paying to be rocking a wig on the regular at 16. I don't know who house you live in, but not in mine. Sorry.
Wow.
That's gonna be a thumbs down for a regular.
Yeah, like I said, I'm just seeing a lot of the young women. And
my daughter told she's in middle school. She's in the seventh grade. She said girls come to school with the lashes. The fake lashes.
That's a whole nother episode. I ain't talking about the lashes on here today. I'm not.
We not gonna do that.
I can't, because I can't even get into y'all walking around here looking like Mr. Snuffleupagus with them.
Snuffleupagus.
You know, Snuffleupagus had them big old eyelash. Like, come on.
They were gorgeous, but they were huge.
Some of them ladies out there, I don't even see how y'all keep your eyes open. How?
I don't see
how do you
they
hold all of
see?
That up.
And they, some of them look like, and I saw that meme on the internet, they look like they're getting ready to fly away.
Yes. But I'm just saying in moderation, they're cute, though.
Yes,
cute, but
yes.
And here's
I
another thing, bro.
And
these are cool. Look, if you're out there listening, you just email us. You can do that from our Instagram link. Because I don't know these things. Because now this is, if you put lashes on, don't you have to glue them on?
Yes.
Doesn't that pull, when you have to take them off, doesn't it pull from the real lashes you got?
Yes. That's why I don't understand why women are paying $50 like a fill-in every 2 weeks to get lashes redone. You've now created a situation where you can't stop.
So then
when you do stop, you barely have any eyelashes. Yes, you barely have any eyelashes left.
So the funny thing is, my niece lives in Dallas. And my niece is like a girly girl, but she be on her grind and hustling. She got a little boutique that, you know, she sells stuff and stuff like that. So she had the eyelashes when she was in town. And I talked to her about it. I was like, yo. And because she said she was missing one, or she was looking for one or something like that. I'm like, so did it just fall off, or did you
take
it off?
Wait, now she lost the whole lash.
Yeah, so I was asking her about the glue thing. And I was like, so do you soak? Like, how do you get it off? She's like, nah, you take a warm rag. And you just got to be delicate. And you know, I say, is it taking your other eyelashes? And my sister was like, yeah, it surely is. It's taking the other eyelashes off. And I was like, okay, all right, well, that's what y'all do. That's what y'all do. But I feel like
it's more of a special occasion type thing, not an everyday type thing.
Yeah. Wow. Okay. But like,
yeah,
I said,
we go through a lot,
things,
man. We
the
go
things
through
y'all
a lot.
Do for beauty. The things y'all do for beauty. So that's what I'm saying. I'm telling women, when you do it right, all that work you put into that, okay, you know, go ahead on. Do your thing, girl.
Thank you.
I appreciate it. I'm going to tell you right now, I appreciate the beauty that you're going through.
But the pain.
I see. It is some pain.
The lost eyelashes.
Because I'd be damned if I put some dress shoes on that don't fit my feet and I'm walking around. I'd be damned if I do some shit like that. Not
you're like, no can do. Not over here.
Not going to happen. But yeah, boo, the corns on your feet, that's a deal breaker.
That's a no.
No nap time with corns on your feet. Let me stop.
You like Marcus and Boomerang?
Yeah, exactly.
Saw them corns and instantly he was like,
that fine, have hammer time in her shoes. I don't get it.
Exactly.
I don't understand it. You're going to make me go look at Boomerang today.
Hey, it popped up on my like trending or something like that. I'm like, look at Boomerang.
Yo, Boomerang is always going to be a classic. Don't forget, Eddie Murphy is coming back. He's in a movie with Nia Long, plays his wife, and what's the girl name who dated Nunu from
Lauren London.
Yeah, Lauren London. Lauren London is playing a daughter in there, and she's getting married to a white Jewish guy, and it's just a whole thing. The movie, I can't even think of the name of the movie, but it was written by Kenya Barris, who's behind Blackish.
Okay.
Yeah. So that should be very fun. I don't know when that's going to be in theaters. And speaking of Nia Long is, we talked about the Best Man Chronicles, which is right. out now. She's also got another movie out called Missing that's in theaters. Look, Nia Long is doing her thing.
I see.
But don't call it a comeback. Nia's always been that bitch.
When life gives you lemons, yeah. you make champagne.
In my
okay,
eyes.
She's yeah. going to keep on moving. She'll be fine. Damn,
What is my your phone bad. Doing, Boog? You
I'm sorry.
You need to get T-Mobile and stop playing. I don't know who you got. You need to.
Stop oh all that. My
you,
you got God! Cricket?
You got Cricket?
No.
But you got Mint.
Why you be?
Who you got?
Why you be doing me like that? I do have T-Mobile. We talk about this.
Oh no, I'm just playing with you, Boog. But Boog, I still I'm think you need to step up your game and get this iPhone.
No, I'm going to step up my game and get the new Samsung Galaxy.
Get your iPhone. Boy, what are we on, the iPhone 14? Boy,
oh,
go
my
and get
God.
You the 14.
It's going to take me too long to have to learn how to really work it.
It.
I just know
learn.
The
don't
basics.
Do that. No, it ain't that much. It's easy. Get your iPhone. iPhone will run your house. You can turn on your air conditioner. You probably can turn on your truck from your iPhone.
Wow.
You can check the weather. You can check the rain that doesn't fail. It'll tell you a joke. Siri does everything. Boog, I'm telling you, you need to get with this iPhone life. Get with it, because that Android ain't hitting right now.
Oh, okay. So says you.
Android is Star Trek. iPhone is Star Wars. Okay, it's a difference. It's
a you know what? Difference. Bye.
It's a motherfucking difference. You don't understand, motherfucking difference. All right, hey, episode 147, thank you for joining us. Like I said, Gene is under the weather, not feeling good. Like I said, between R&B Bingo and the whole Greek skate step-off that was last weekend.
Oh, yeah, on
baby.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's why Gene is
sold out. Gene is woed down.
Yeah, that's why Gene is not. Gene need to get his electrolytes back, probably drink some Pedialyte or something. Because he's got to rejuvenate from all of that
Man,
foolishness.
Hey, I'm going to say it again. Follow him on Instagram, gene.com. Yes. Spell it all yes. out. The R&B Bingo, the videos from it, the chronicles. Yes. Man, I look forward to that.
Yes. Like I
Duval
said.
Duval be showing up and showing out.
They got that man in the bed with a skull cap on. Where they do that at in Duval County? That's where they do that shit at, in Duval County. And you know,
big
next,
up to the Jaguars.
Big up
Go
to the Jaguars.
Jags.
Yeah, don't forget this weekend taking on the Chiefs. This is the divisional round. You know, next episode we're going to talk about this whole Duval thing, Boog, because I feel like it's so watered down now, and it's getting like when I heard Al Michaels say it during the game, and of course you cringed. I did cringe. I was like, get the fuck out of here! Like, we're going to talk about that next episode. I mean,
okay,
I don't want to tell Florida, everybody else is out. I don't want
to
tell people not to say it, but I'm like, come on. Shout out to Lil Duval too. Lil Duval is back, you know, his recovery is going well. He was at the game last week. Smile, bitch, come on. So yeah, shout out to Lil Duval. He's actually hitting the road again too. So he's going to be out on the road. Follow him on his socials. He'll let you know those days. So it's good to see him back after that car accident. And once again, you know, if you look at his socials, man, he couldn't even walk, Boog.
Yeah, man.
So just for him to be back.
Bad.
Yeah, it was very bad. Very bad. So it's good to see him back. Let me see. We got any more shout-outs we got to give? Trevor Lawrence, my black brother.
Man, shout out to Trevor Lawrence again.
Do your thing this weekend, Trevor. Do your thing, okay?
You know, it's some people that get that honorary pass. You know, I'm feeling like he's one of those dudes.
Trevor Lawrence, y'all win this weekend. I will buy out the Waffle House for you, homeboy.
Oh,
definitely.
My gosh.
I told you, smothered in chunk, whatever you want. I got it. I got it for you, all right?
Hey, guess what? How much you want to bet is going to be folks hanging out at the Waffle House just waiting to see if he comes back. Yep. Stop playing. It's only like 3 miles from my house, bro.
Oh my
I can
gosh.
Go.
I thought it was so hilarious, though. So he's going to the Waffle House, you know. All right. Yeah. I can't think of anybody else. Once again, like I said, familyradioonline.com. Go there. You can listen to all past episodes. Our socials are there waiting on you. The Family Radio on Instagram. I think I covered everything. And we are at all of the podcast platforms. We're there. Anything else? Book, I don't even know what song we're going to go out on today. I don't even know.
You know what? Okay, we got to think about this. Who put out a new Jaguar rap?
Book, no, I'm not going to do that. No. I'm not going to do that for
okay.
you. Because let me tell you something. After the last game, I got like 10 emails. Everybody want to have a Jaguar damn hype
we
song.
We going to the Super Bowl rap. That,
No, can't do that. And I mean, ugh. Book, we was dealing for that for a long time, every year. And I mean, I even got stuff professionally done. Like one of the dudes that was on American Idol, like so they sent one to every team because they wanted every team to play it. I'm like, this is some bullshit. I'm not playing this. Like, like, what are y'all doing? Like, come on.
No, thank you.
But yeah.
We'll pass.
So yeah, that's another thing. We're not going to play that. You know what I'm going to play? What's the
Coyle
Ray? I like Coyle Ray new song. The remix of it. Players. Coyle Ray, that's what we're going out on.
Look at you, Tim.
Yes.
It's the family.
Ladies getting money all around the world, cause girls is players too. What you know about living on the top? Penthouse suites, looking down on the ops. Took her for a test drive, left them on the lot. Time is money, so I spent it on a watch. Hold on, little bitty showing through the white tee. You can see the thong busting on my tight jeans.
Okay.
Rocks on my fingers like he wanna wife me. Got another shorty, she ain't nothing like me. Yeah, about to catch another flight. Yeah, apple bottom make him wanna bite. Yeah, I just wanna have a good night. I just wanna have a good night. Hold up, if you don't know, now you know. If you broke, then you gotta let him go. You could have anybody, any money mo. Cause when you a boss, you could do what you want. Yeah, cause girls is players too. Yeah, yeah, cause girls is players too.
Keep playing, baby.
Cause girls is players too. Ladies getting money all around the world, cause girls is players too. I go on and on and on again. He blowing on my phone, but I'm ignoring him. He thinking he the one, I got like four of him. Yeah, I'm sitting first class like Bad Victorian. Came a long way from rag to riches. Five star food, yeah, I taste so delicious. Let him lick the plate, yeah, I make him do the dishes. Now he on News 12 cause a bitch we're missing. Jeez. About to catch another flight, yeah. Apple bottom make him wanna bite, yeah. I just wanna have a good night. I just wanna have a good night. Hold up, if you don't know, now you know. If you broke, then you gotta let him go. You could have anybody, any money mo. Cause when you a boss, you could do what you want. Yeah, cause girls is players too.
And it's time that we let them know that
girls is players too.
Keep playing, baby.
Cause girls is players too. Ladies getting money all around the world, cause girls is players too.
The Family Radio Podcast with T-Boogie, Gene.com, and Chill Will.